Good morning, okay. Secretary, over here.
No,
good
not.
To see you again. I'm hoping you can give me a little clarity and understanding about funds that come in, I think, from the federal government, the IDEA funds for disabilities. So can you tell, how much do we receive or do you receive in those funds?
I'm going to defer that to our expert, Deputy Secretary Stem, but we can definitely pull the, if you bear with us, we can pull those numbers for you.
And while you're looking for that, because I'm on the clock here,
yes,
I'm just
going
to ask my next question. It's my understanding that the state is not required to report how those funds are used. So is that correct?
Your specific use for those funds. You can't use them for anything, but you have to use them for FAPE, which is free and appropriate education for students who have special needs.
So you look to see how they're spent. You know where that money's going.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Okay.
In aggregate.
So does the federal government.
Yeah, and so does the federal government.
Yeah, so that right, that's what we're just going to add. So two things. Let me give you the numbers. For 2018-19, our IDEA Part B funds were $446,896,000 and change. In 2019-20, our IDEA Part B funding was $449,731,000 and change. And as the Secretary shared, there are I might get this wrong, 18 or 19 categories that we track and we have to report out through our annual OSEP reporting to the federal government. And we are happy to just put a little plug in for our team at the department. We're the only large state in the nation to have fully passed our OSEP reporting 9 out of the last 10 years, I believe.
Okay. So I understand there's something called technical assistant consultants that are through the IUs.
That's correct.
Correct? Which are funded with this fund, is that?
That's correct. There's five FTEs in each of the IUs that are funded as part of the set aside from IDEA.
Okay, but and then there's something else, and I'm not sure if I'm going to say it right. It's either PATN or PATAN funding that only
correct.
Goes to three IUs.
Those are that's right. So those the three PATANs run through three IUs. That's correct. And they're the
technical for like 138 employees, I think, in those three IUs. And then what do they help the other IUs? Are they helping the school districts? Like I'm confused why there's two different levels of IU funding or where that money's going.
Yeah.
No, so that's a great question. So we have three PATANs, and I'll do this quickly for you. There's one in the Pittsburgh region, one here in Harrisburg, and one that's located in Malvern. And what they do is, and this went in place, predated our administration, but it was a system that was put in place to put in place specific technical assistance and training to all schools in those regions. So Malvern handles the entire East region, Harrisburg handles Central, and Pittsburgh handles the West. And so you're talking about really specialized training, training for our IUs and also training directly to school districts free of charge. And it falls within our responsibilities under IDEA to provide that support.
Well, can the school districts apply directly for that funding without going through these three PATAN systems, the three schools?
You mean could schools directly get funding that goes to the patent, to the technical assistance network?
Yeah.
I would have to follow up with you on that because there are federal requirements around technical assistance, so we'd have to get back to you with a specific answer on how that funding would work. There's the TAC funding and also the patent funding, which are two different sets of funding.
So, okay, I guess I'm just not clear on if the school districts can apply themselves, which I had heard they could, because this is new to me. I'd never heard of this program before. So I'm just trying to understand if the school districts can apply themselves, why they have to go through the other system. So, and I was just wondering if you had any correspondence that you had sent out to the schools to tell them how to apply for that.
That's not, in my 5 years at the department, that's not something that's been raised as an issue or even a question that we've responded to. So that's why we'd have to get back with the team and then.
If you could, I'd appreciate that. And I think the other thing is then, so this money comes in every year. So if you're training staff, I mean, that seems like a lot of money that keeps going for training staff that's going out to train others. I guess I'm just a little not clear on how that's being used, and just want to make sure we're getting the best bang for our dollar.
Sure.
So thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Sure.